Hi guys, it's Mike here. Today I wanted to show you how I made a sequin dress and how I did some partial foiling on a Hurra die cut. This dress is a remake of this drawing I made a long time ago, and it's an 8x11 sheet, so I wanted to do something smaller. But first the die cutting. I used Hurra. I think it's from Nelly Snellen. I'm not sure. I took it out of the packaging. But using the Heidi Swap reactive spray, and I'm brushing it on with an old and gnarly brush, because you know it's a glue kind of thing, and I put it in water immediately. So I'm brushing it on really liberally, you know, not paying attention, but just only halfway through the die cut and leave it to dry. So I made one earlier, and I don't know if you can see. Then I wanted to use it with a Penny Black stamp, and to, you know, trying to choose a color. Oh, this is my reactive paper that you can order, but then you get a whole die cut, and I wanted it, you know, like it's distressed. And I chose this dark blue from Wow Fabfoil, because it has a bit of a purpley into it, and I thought that would be nice and girly. So putting a piece of printer paper as my carrier sheet and a piece of the Fabfoil onto the side where the spray is, and then I pass it through my laminator and you peel it off. And because you applied it with a brush, you get these really streaky edges. I kind of like that, and was exactly what I was after, so easy. I was clapping there to myself, like, yay. Sometimes things go right. To make it sturdier, I die cut another one, and I'm trying to glue them together with some multi-matte medium. Why do they make these things so difficult to say? And I'm just using my finger, so, you know, to wipe it. And there was a cat hair. Sorry about that. Cat house, cat hair. So you have to be careful with that multi-matte medium, because if it goes onto your shiny fab foil, it will matte that foil as well. And, you know, the whole point in using foils, using it for the shiny stuff. This is Penny Black stamp set XOXO, and I'm using Memento because I'm gonna do some Spectrum Noir and Copic coloring. Actually, I didn't need to use the Copics. I just want to show you can use them together. And this is a Nina Solar White. And let's make it a nice stitch shape. So before I start coloring, I'll pass it through my Big Shot. My plates are a bit bowed, so I had to pass it through again. And I like to do it on an angle. Usually cuts better that way. So for the coloring, I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and I will turn on the music, and I will see you again after. So here I'm with the multi-medium, matte medium, I can't say it, again, and I first wanted the hooray, the sentiment to go across the panel, but now I put it in a corner. And I thought about adding a few more sequins to the side, but I thought, you know, the glittery dress and glittery sentiment, that would, you know, be more than enough. I hope you liked it. And I will see you again soon, because I have another video planned. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye.